Silkworm, the arcade to NES port. Man, there were a lot of these. This is a basic side-scrolling shooter, but with a twist. You can fly in a helicopter or ride in a Jeep. Ooh. I think the advantage is the helicopter, because you can move in all directions, and when you hold down B, you angle down and can shoot stuff on the ground. The Jeep can fire backwards, and it can jump. That's pretty impressive in itself. When you're playing multiplayer, the first player is always the helicopter, and the second player is the Jeep. Does anything I'm saying remind you of a Silkworm? I just don't understand the name. Maybe it has to do with the Silk Power Ranger suit that the driver of the Jeep and the pilot are wearing. When you're kicking ass, Silk is the only way to go. Maybe not. Either way, it's a basic shooter with a weird name. The storyline is really generic.
In the 1990s, scientists had completed the artificial brain, MHC-2. However, the MHC-2 surpassed the intelligence of its creators and began to go against their commands. It conspired to take over the world in order to rule over man as their god. The MHC-2 began to control the weapons of the world.
Robert, Stacy, get in the G-Cobra and B-Panther and set out immediately.
This game is hard as hell. Without the Game Genie, you're better off playing the game with your feet. It's that crazy. Even the level-up system is hard. It takes 250,000 points to get a weapon upgrade. And by that time, you're on level 6. And there's only 8 levels. You can get a temporary weapons upgrade after killing a number of enemies. Then a couple of ships come together to form a goose. You know what? Nobody's ever going to play this game again because it's so hard. So I'm going to spoil the ending with some narration from Perfect Liz.
We did it. The world is safe again.
Looks like you fell into my trap. I'm just a decoy. This world will be ours.
What? What do you mean?
Your home base is probably in ruins by now. This area will go up in smoke in 30 seconds. Say your prayers.
We've been had. Oh no, the ENF ball is being destroyed. We're too late. Where is he? He's probably absorbing the energy from the ENF ball to build up his power. Be careful.
Does that make any sense? I don't think so. And the final boss, a giant purple thing. As usual, you save the world and get a good job from the Colonel. You get to see the sunrise and a speech on how the Earth is back to normal. The end, or N, as you see here. That's it, a frozen end screen. You have to turn off your NES or hit the reset button to continue. I guess they figured you've suffered enough if you played through the whole game.